Hello, it's Sunday, September 25th, and I'm Tony Christopher, financial analyst at UFX Markets Trading Support Center. This is your week in review. Today, we will discuss some of the major financial events of the past week and how they impacted the currency and commodity markets. The US dollar fell against the euro after home purchases in the US fell unexpectedly. According to the Commerce Department, sales of new homes fell by 13.4%. Existing home sales, however, remained strong, and investors were encouraged by the results of the last FOMC meeting, during which most members expressed their support for an imminent reduction to the central bank's bond purchasing program. The Canadian dollar hit a six-week low against the US dollar after the release of disappointing data regarding the Canadian economy. Wholesale and retail sales slumped in Canada, and consumer price gains are below the central bank's inflation target. Other important indicators, among them risk appetite and economic output, fueled speculation that the Canadian economy is slowing. The Canadian dollar was last trading against the US dollar at the level of 1.0493, which is a decrease of 0.20%. On Friday, the pound was headed for a weekly drop against the US dollar, its first in 3 weeks, and for its steepest weekly fall against the euro since May. The UK currency fell against the US dollar after Martin Wheel, a Bank of England policymaker, said that the central bank might extend its asset purchasing. Better than expected consumer confidence data from the euro area caused the pound to fall against the euro, but a report showing that second quarter economic expansion in the UK beat investors' expectations contributed to the current optimism regarding the UK economy. The pound was last trading against the US dollar at the level of 1.5563, which is a decrease of 0.15%. In commodity news, gold hit an 11-week high after worse-than-expected new home sales data was released in the US, leading to increased speculation among investors that the Federal Reserve will maintain its stimulus measures for the time being. Further contributing to the spike in the price of gold was increased demand in Asia for jewelry, bars, and coins. Gold was last trading at the level of $1,391.15, which is an increase of 1.15%. The discouraging new home sales also triggered a spike in WTI crude oil. Better than expected consumer confidence in the euro area and ongoing violence in Syria and in Egypt also contributed to the rise in crude oil futures. WTI crude oil was last trading at the level of $106.42, which is an increase of 1.32%. Well, that's our summary of the financial headlines from the past week. We hope you've enjoyed this week's review and that you'll tune in tomorrow morning as we kick off the new trading week with the latest top market news. Until then, be sure to log in to ufxmarkets.com for all of your trading needs. Your personal account manager is ready to answer all of your questions. UFX Markets Trading Support Center wishes you a successful trading week.